let you know when the preach word comes forth, we're going to be in Matthew 4, verses 12 to 16. Matthew 4, verses 12 through 16. That's where apostles will be preaching from. Just a couple announcements. We're still waiting for Preach the Word Network to have their airing of the 2020 Shining Stars Awards. We all know that we received the award, but with the current pandemic, we said we're not going to go out to Atlanta to be quarantined back 2 weeks, so we decided to stay here. But that should be airing soon. We are going to go next year, and we hope to bring double the people that we have for tickets from this year. I think we sold like 10 tickets, and it was good, so 10 of us was on our way down. But we'll make up for that, amen? 20 going back. That's right, 20 going back, double. All right, so where's our little offering? We have the kids participate in service of faith starting on.
Such as weddings, homegoing services, et cetera, et cetera. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Come on, y'all. So I call to you without further ado, Mr. Terry Lee and Mr. Carla Holloway. Now, some of you out there may be saying, they don't have any masks or anything like that. But the reason why we don't have them is because we've been living not a quarantine life, but a consecrated life.
Amen.
In other words, it's just been us. So we know where we've been. Here.
And we still practice all our social
distance. Still practice all social distance and all that nature.
Yes.
But what I'm saying is, if you can change the course of what's happening in the ministry, if some of y'all would just start to get consecrated and stop being fake-aided. In other words, when, you know, just sitting around talking a whole lot of holy nonsense and not really coming to the real sense of what God is trying to do. Amen? So it's time to start really practicing what you preach. You know, it's time to start coming together and doing what you're supposed to do instead of what you're not supposed to do. So without further ado...
May I say something to
you? Absolutely.
So these are our two teachers y'all know from Angels and Wilson School, who's decided to work in the ministry also by teaching. then sometimes we must have regular teachers. We have extraordinary ones. So we want to make sure you're licensed as a minister and teacher this afternoon, amen? Okay?
On this day of our Lord, September 13, 2020. Now people say 13 is a bad number. Well, you're wrong. The fact of the matter is 13 is the perfect number because there was 12 disciples plus Jesus.
Amen.
He was the 13th in the group. So maybe that's why you can't get anywhere with 13 coming up because God's not having it. On the day of our Lord, September 13, 2020, licensed as a minister of teaching in the body of Christ by the lines of Jude's seven ministries, Isaiah 61, the Lord God is upon me. Right now, God is upon you to go out and to teach and show them what's right, how to do what's right, in excellence, something that you will do well. Thank you for your continued service to this ministry. You're an inspiration. Truly you are. Y'all are an inspiration. You're always reaching higher, and that is true. We really, truly appreciate y'all.
Yes, we do.
You're a family,
yes, family,
and we welcome you into the symbolic of this. 1 Chronicles 12:8. And the Gadites there separate themselves unto David, unto the whole, to the wilderness, men of might, men of war, fit for the battle, that could handle shield and buckler, whose faces were like the faces of lions, or swift as the roes upon the mountains. So this ring represents we're separated unto the line. We're warriors unto the line. We move swift unto the line. And you may say, oh, you're worshiping the line. No, because of this. Revelation chapter 5. And I saw at the right hand of him that sat on the throne, a book written, and within on the backside, sealed with seven seals, I saw a strong angel who came with a loud voice, who's worthy to open the book, who's loosened the seals thereof. And no man in heaven nor on earth, neither under the earth, was able to open the book, neither the book thereon. And I wept much, because no man felt worthy to open to read the book, but neither to look therein. And one of the elders said unto me, weep not, behold, the Lion, the tribe of Judah, the root of David, which prevailed upon the book, and to loose the seven seals thereof. Jesus is the Lion of Judah. He is the Lion of Judah. So what we're saying is that we have committed ourselves as the Lion of Judah for him. His representation on earth. But see, people are running around doing all kinds of signs and symbols like them stars and all that stuff, not knowing what it is and why you have it or why you should be wearing it. Revelation 5 says, one of the elders said to me, weep not, behold the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the root of David, have prevailed upon the book, and to loose the seven seals. Right now, that's part of our mission, is to loose the seven seals of what God has for the world and what needs to be done. This is the mission. And the seven seals has various different things that God is going to do in a way of a blessing for people. There's nothing in the seven seals that ain't you. So, as you come up and receive this signet ring, we also use this to stand and get yourself some wax or something like that. You want to make sure it's official from one of us. You take it, you put oil on it, you stamp it on the wax, and you seal your envelope so that you know that this is where it came from. Amen? So without further ado, I'm going to call first Vanessa Worley. Stay standing. Take a seat and stay standing. Stay standing. Don't worry, you're standing. After you get your room, just stay standing. Pay attention. Papa Sierra. And it's the face outward. It's a sacred thing, so don't put it and mix it up with everybody and everything else. Don't put it up on the altar. If you have a child, don't get one and put it there. Wear it. Leave it. It's been sitting on the altar for exactly 3 days. This would be. Okay, I'm going to meet you. Minister Terry, come forward. Mr. Carla, I have a friend for you. You're right, you are family. All right, please stay standing. Oh, don't forget your head. Please keep it in those bags. Papa's margarita. Prophet Zeres. the Gadites.
They have
separated themselves. This signifies that you are separated. Unto David.
Unto
the whole.
Unto the wilderness.
Women of might.
Women of war.
I said, women of war.
Women of war.
I ain't no war. Women of war.
Women of war.
Fit for the battle.
That can handle the shield.
And the buckler. Swiftly, warriors, a great work is ahead of us. And I say to you this day, Revelation 5, 5, which is the fivefold apostolic. And one of the elders said to me, weep not. Weep not no longer, ladies. Behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the root of David, has prevailed upon the book. Whatever was written in that book against you by the devil, you have prevailed against it. Whatever they said you cannot do, you have prevailed against it. Whatever people have put in your way, you have prevailed against it. And to loose the seven seals, each one of you represents a loosing of a seal. So I speak unto you right now, the name of Jesus, loose. Loose the anointing, O Father. Loose the anointing upon these women of God. Loose the anointing in their households, in their finances, in their relationships, in their community, Lord. In the things that you have given them, gifts, Lord. Loose it right now in the name of Jesus. Equip them even more, Lord. Give them the armor of fire, fire, fire in the name of Jesus. The healing flow from them. In the name of Jesus, hold on to your seals and remember this day what God has done. Give God a praise. You may be seated. Explain something to all of y'all today. Why so many things have been going on and why you have issues. Why were you chosen? Why am I doing this? Why? Well, God told me to tell you today. He has taken you beyond the Jordan. God has prepared you, he says, for my destiny. You didn't hear what I just said. God has prepared you, and he says these words, for my destiny. God is preparing you for his destiny for your life. See, the problem is that we went around here trying to find destiny. When you don't find destiny, destiny finds you. And destiny finds you once you get across the Jordan. But some of you got across the Jordan and you stuck at the banks. Well, I'm saved. Well, that's true, but what happens after that? What do you think you're supposed to do? Do a whole bunch of hallelujahs and do a whole bunch of offerings, and that means that you're serving God? Or that God is using you? Oh, I know what's right. I know what's right. You think it's right because you can't pass this Bible. Give him some soft drinks. That's not your destiny. Serving is not destiny. It's the action that gets you to the destiny. But when you find yourself just serving a man and not serving God, then you've completely lost your way and destiny. I'm talking to somebody today. When you find yourself serving a job, that's why it's a job, because you're serving a job instead of walking in the destiny of God. That's why some things are not working out for you, because you're not walking in the destiny of God. You say, well, I'm serving, I give and I do. Yeah, that might be true, but is that the destiny of God for your life? Some might say, well, I'm a good wife. Okay, that may be true, but your marriage is not the destiny of your life. It's the partner that walks with you into the destiny of your life. Some of you say, well, you know, once I get married, I'm going to be your destiny. Once you get married, you may not be. In fact, you may even get out of destiny. Well, I don't hear that. Because whatever you're in, is for to walk with you into destiny. Your career is not your destiny. It's just a place of education and learning. That is not your destiny. Destiny is much greater than that. You mean to tell me destiny is ending with a master's degree? That's destiny? Destiny is with a bachelor's degree. That's destiny? Oh, I know. If you become a millionaire, that's destiny. That ain't destiny. Destiny is something that lives even after you're gone. Which makes you still alive on earth. You know you're walking in destiny, but the residuals of where you were or were at is still there. I'm talking to somebody. You know you was walking in destiny, residuals you being there is still there. Somebody is still saying, because of this, I can do this, and because of that, I can do that, and because of this, I got a better way of doing things, and because of that, I don't have to be stuck for, and because of that, I can take care of myself, and because of that, my God, you know, I was really down, and because of that individual, God used them, it was the vessel. This is how I got to here, and there, and here, and there, and there. Is that going on with you? But let's get more education with this thing. Beyond the joy, God is preparing you for, he says, my destiny. So the definition of the Jordan, what the Jordan was. The Jordan River, or River Jordan, also known as Nahr and Al-Sharat, which is Arabic. The Jordan River has an upper course from its source to the Sea of Galilee. So, the Jordan River has an upper course from its source. So the Sea of Galilee feeds the River Jordan. And is another 210 meters so that the river meanders before entering into the Dead Sea. A terminal lake about 422 meters below sea level with no outlet. So Galilee is the upper Rome. And the only way you can get there is by going up the River Jordan. Let me say it again. Galilee feeds the Jordan. And the only way you can get to Galilee is you go up the Jordan. But if you go down the Jordan, you end up in the Dead Sea. And it's below sea level, so it's lower than low. Now the question I ask y'all today, have you been meandering up or meandering down? The Jordan. After you cross the Jordan, did you decide to walk up the banks saved out of that situation, then you decide to walk up or lay down. Rest a while. Take it easy. My God, after you finally got what you wanted, did you decide to take it to a high level or let it drop down to a lower level? After you got in that relationship that you wanted, did you take that relationship to a high level or did you just let it meander down to a lower level? Ooh-wee. But God says, I am preparing you for my destiny. And my destiny is beyond the Jordan. So in order for you to be in destiny, you got to go beyond your Jordan. Oh, you got to go beyond. And it wasn't just enough just to cross. Some of y'all say, well, I crossed them. Now I'm good. No. Now that you crossed over, you got a choice to make. Do you want to meander up or meander down? See, we think that crossing over the Jordan meant you got free. Crossing over the Jordan meant you had another decision to make. Yes, you got free from slavery, but you didn't get free from death. You got free from slavery, but you didn't get free from imminent danger. You got free from slavery, but you didn't get free from the bondage of poverty. You didn't get free from any of these things. The only way you can truly get out of any of these things is if you start to walk up the Jordan. Now, somewhere in 1 Chronicles says something about being swift. How is it that rivers move swift, but it says this meandering down the Jordan? So it must mean that when the current is going one way, it's moving slow. So when you're going down, 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 baby, down by the roller coaster, when you are going down, you start to slow down. When you are going down the Jordan, you start to slow down. When you're going down the Jordan, you start to slow down. But when you're going up the Galilee and you're going into destiny, you start to speed up. You start to get momentum. You're like a, oh my God, you're like a track star. How do you hit the top, take off in the gate? Now you start, man, my God, you start running. My God, you start striding out. After a while, you're like a gazelle. Striding out. But when you're in the afternoon, you like droopy dog. You just laying around, yeah. When you sit down, you're grunting and carrying. You looking at everybody sleepy and droopy. You just What you want to do? No. What's up? No.
Why is everybody always picking on me?
Charlie Brown. Uh-oh. Got quiet at the cricket set. So now we're going to the scripture, Matthew 4. It's prophetic in its intent. Let it find you in your right place. Matthew 4, verse 12 through 16. Five verses that can change your life. Now, when Jesus had heard John was cast into prison. Hold up. No, let me make sure you're there, because I want you to see this. By the way, when I do sermons, ain't nothing but the word up there. Ain't nothing else there. So I don't have to meditate for 20 days and do this ceremonial thing just to speak the word of God. You just got to speak the word.
Can you say amen? Amen. Now when Jesus had heard that John was cast into prison, he departed unto Galilee. How many of y'all have felt like you've been cast into prison in some place in your life? Come on, talk back to me. Y'all got the amens. How many of y'all have felt like somewhere in your life you've been cast into a prison? Seems like you just can't get out of that thing. Oh, come on, y'all, talk back to me. Said, I can't get out of that thing. Everything else going on, but just this thing right here. This thing right here. This right here. I can't seem to get out of it. Now, when Jesus heard that John was cast into prison, let me tell you this today. Jesus done heard that you've been cast in some prison in your life somewhere. Come on, talk back. He knows somewhere in your life right now there's a prison cell. Jesus heard that you were cast into prison, and he departed up to Galilee, so he said, I'm going into the upper room for you. I heard that you got you in a prison somewhere. Something in your life ain't going the way you want it to go. So I'm going into the upper room for you. And leaving Nazareth, he came and dwelt at Capernaum, which is upon the sea coast, in the borders of Zebulun and Naphtali. See, I knew that some of y'all got some prison things going on inside of you. That's why instead of going to the mountain, I chose to go to the sea to get away. And so while y'all was all sitting around and beaching and doing all this stuff, I was doing what Jesus did. I only fished and I only meditated on the word. And I sat there and that's what I did. Because I said, Father, somebody got to break some stuff for some of them out there. Somebody got to speak a word, say something, because it's not right. It's not right. Some of them are working really hard, God. It's not right that they got this prison thing going on with them. They don't belong in jail. And Father said, I know. I just was waiting for somebody to speak up about it. I said, well, praise God, I did what you said. He said, that it may be fulfilled, which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet. That it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet. But what do you mean, Apostle? There's been some things that's been spoke into your life that's powerful. There is some things that needed to be spoken to your life that's powerful. There is some freedoms that need to be spoken to your life that's powerful. There's some healing that's spoken to your life that's powerful. Yeah, my God, there's some stamps and seals of approval of sickness that says this thing is supposed to happen for you, because where you're at is not where you're supposed to be at right now. And I don't think that you're doing all that you're supposed to do with God, but God got something greater for you. See, prophet is told, he got something greater for you. He got something greater for you. It was never meant for you to be bound up in the society where what they do, not really want to do what it really takes to really do what it really needed to be done. Your children, something greater for you than even the house that you, oh my God, you ain't heard what I was saying. And you may say, I'm not no prophet. Well, that's a lie. You really are, but see, the problem is everybody trying to dummy it down or get you to dummy down, because they don't really want you to see. It's funny, because Terry, you have it as well. You have prophecy, but you dummy it down. Because you don't think, well, maybe because, you know, we all got world things we might do. You might get your little tasty taste every now and then. You might get your little smoke every now and then. All these things may be going on, but that does not disqualify you for the destiny that God has set up for you. I cancel down the bond of forgiveness right now in the name of Jesus. You can't, oh my God, that's the prison that's holding. We live
But if you know that Jesus died on this thing called the cross for you, so that you can be free to serve and do what God needs you to do, in the condition that you're in, then you can be free.
Well, the apostle just told you today, now what you want to do?
And in front of a pile of whole witnesses all over Facebook,
yeah, I said it. Them two right there, I said it. Now what? And if your family members you don't like it, na-na-na-na, boo-boo, you know what the rest says.
Because see, what happens is that's another thing that's going on. A lot of y'all are captive by your families. They have put you in a prison, in a box. And they want you to be like them, do like them, talk like them, walk like them. But they don't want to give to you like they give to them. They don't want to be helping you like they helping them. They don't want to be, my God, they ain't think about you when it go real bad. And when you're being bad, they don't mind you being down with them because they down, down, baby, down by the roller coaster. See, they don't mind while you going down stuff. But the minute you committed, my God, the minute you committed, you trying to do some up stuff, now you got so much to say about your life. Stop believing some of the lies. Who are they to tell you, oh, well, you shacking up? There is no shacking up in the Bible, so stop telling people that. Uh-oh. Nowhere does this, thou shalt not shack up, for thou art going to hell. You better stop playing.
People say, okay, here it is again. They smoking weed. Well, yes. Well, until God put a scripture in there, thou shalt not smoke weed. And I don't smoke weed. But until he put that in there, I can't be right. You going to hell, you're smoking weed.
Why are we doing this stuff? Because we're putting people into captivity for the devil. So God, they think they're not worthy to talk, to walk, to be with God because of y'all religiousness and y'all doing stuff that ain't not your business to do. People want to be real ministers, but the fake ministers won't let them do it. But they do. My God. People want to be real pastors, but the fake pastors won't let them get up to do it. People want to be real pastors, but the fake pastors won't let them get up to do it. People want to be real pastors, but the fake apostles won't do what they got to do. So the people can really be used. My God, they can be used. Possible to do his work, his will, his work.
Probably sick of this. So I'm here to let you know today, get into the upper room, coming from Galilee, it is time for you to walk in your destiny in spite of what they told you you cannot do. In spite of their rule and their regulations that don't have nothing to do with you. Oh, it's quiet in here. How many of you not done something because some people talk about you so bad you scared to do it? How many of y'all got so much guilt because whatever little thing that you do, you just feel like you can't even go into the house of God because you feel funny? They sneak at night too. Pastors getting their freak on the low. I don't want to hear this. Some of them got some municipal or weed. Or maybe they got municipal weed, I don't know. They do, and they can hide it now. Because they got the weed bud over here and the camera there, bless them the Lord. I got a revelation today. No, you had some weed today. Wow, he's busting on people. No, I'm a pastor. I have the right to do this. It's my job. And all I'm saying, I'm not judging anybody. But what I'm saying is, time you stop judging and getting in the way of what God's trying to do with the people for their destiny and purpose in here. Mothers, you should be ashamed of yourself. If your child said they want to do something positive, stop putting them down just because they what you want. Oh, DeJuan, he's going to be a football player. Because you think about him buying your house. That's why DeJuan don't never end up being a football player. He may be in being a foot player because you, Jesus. you gotta go out there and be a ballerina. That's why she turned into a pole dancer, because you done sat there and you think about what she gotta do, and I'll take care of you.
Killed
with heat of 104 degrees. Mechanical things break down at high temperatures, but do not break down in cold. Now, I'm not one of those conspiracy people, all that craziness, but you got to figure COVID, 5G, don't die in the cold. Create it. Then our friend Mr. Bill Gates wants to get in and bring the cure. Because somewhere down the line, he done figured it out that it's nanotechnology. The number's not adding up. 6 million? How many people's in the United States? How we got 100,000 people dying or more in New Jersey, and New Jersey bigger than from? We ain't got that many. Then most of us should be dead right about now. But look, there's a lot of people moving around. You better go get that census record and fix it real quick, because your lie's coming out. So what I'm saying is this. All of this is still part of the destiny work God is trying to do, because God is trying to show man in this and show us too that no matter what you do, you still can't stop the destiny that I put on people's lives. You still can't stop the destiny of what I'm planning on doing with my people. You still can't stop. You can close down as many church buildings as you want to, but you can't church change that church. Close down the sanctuary. You know, he said, I'm going to be working out of the sanctuaries. And I'm going to be working with my chosen ones. And I'm going to be working with those that want to serve and do good for me. For me. For me. And I'm going to touch their house. I'm going to touch their mouth. I'm going to touch their heart. I'm going to touch their mouth. I'm going to make them in progress in everything that you know out there. The Bible said, trust not thy Lord thy God. So you might say, well, if I am sealed by God, then I shouldn't worry about COVID. No, that means don't tempt him. Yes, he's protecting you. And you might say, well, how can that possibly be? Let me tell you something. Right now, your refrigerator is full of COVID. Because if you went to the supermarket, hallelujah, and got a pack of hamburger, hallelujah, and chicken is as dirty as it can get, hallelujah, and vegetables, they open and people are touching them, hallelujah. Who do you think they did? To pick up the oranges, they're not using God to pick up the tomatoes, they're not using God to pick up the packages. Everybody's handling this stuff. And if it ain't being killed with coal, now fulfill your destiny, thus saith the Lord. Now fulfill your destiny. Now that I've said that little bit, that means that God has been touching you the whole while you've been handling nothing but craziness. You've been walking around touching COVID everywhere, and God still kept you. Not even a bad sneeze. But they done made them forgot about Hep C that's running wild too. That ain't fine to either. Oh my God, and the flu is out too. But that ain't fine to either. That ain't fine to you either. Oh, no! Only thing that's fine to you is a little bit of extra chicken link around your waist because you're eating right. Oh, my God. Just a little bit. I went around, I'm looking at people, I'm thinking myself, my God, you ate the whole thing. I'm just going to like, wow, you ain't really ate the whole thing, did you? Running around talking about, people say, I ain't afraid of no ghosts, I ain't afraid of no COVID. I know that's right. You look like you ate the whole thing. I mean, people that was this big, all they come. Well, COVID been good to you. Skinny people, I'm talking about people like, you can take them, put me a lot, pick it up, put walk into some ball. I'm like, whoa! You were small.
God was good to you. You need to praise the Lord. I'm serious. And the little kids around little meatballs too. Little Pawani to this fat water mommy. Oh girl, the face that got so fat, her hang time or place is just going like this, they're like antennas on her head. We dying from COVID though. I don't know. But it's destiny. Say it's destiny. Because what God is trying to give us a taste of is more life, more abundance. Come on, y'all. Somebody need to get what I'm here saying here. You're still trying to say, that's the sign of somebody that was broken life. They may have been, up until COVID, they could have been starving. But because of this thing, some people's eating that never got to eat. Some people's being able to go and buy that TV that never could buy it. Some people got an opportunity to actually eat that food they never could eat before. So my God, some people, listen, some people said, listen, I'm going to do all this thing. See, why they keep sticking on the pole? Because some people, they've been working so hard for so long. Just to be still just for a minute feels real good. And you got still real good. You got a table full of food. You know what I mean? Everybody getting extra chunky around here. And my God, you can still talk to one another. My God, that's time to give God a praise.
Go beyond the tone for the people that missed you. Talk to
nobody can hurt me. I know that's the place where God is.
Still gotta do, still gotta do, still gotta do.
sitting in darkness. Until you get there, some young woman, some young man, they got to be God's plan and be sitting in darkness. Nonsense. I never talked to him. I never seen him. but you're still pissed off.
start living more here. Prepare for the ultimate destiny, which is your transition. Amen.
Amen.
Beyond the Jordan. God's preparing for you. It is so